Dear Chavedim, a gutevach, a gesuntevach, we are standing Moitzoi Shabbos Parshas Vayetze. We read today the story of Yaakov Avinu leaving the home of his parents. Vayetze Yaakov mi be'er sheva. Yaakov is going to Choron. Tells us the Torah that Vayivka ba'mokoim, literally meaning that Yaakov encountered the place. Tells us Rashi that Vayivka rabiseinu pirshu, Vayivka means prayer. And indeed, Yaakov was the one that instituted the prayer of the evening. Furthermore, the Midrash says that in this pasuk, the word Bamakoim, literally meaning the place, is referring to God Almighty. As we know that there are times that Hashem is referred to with the word Hamakoim. It says in Kisiso, Hine Makoim Iti, etc., etc. Nowadays, there are times that we use the words Hamakoim in reference to God. In other words, here in this pasuk, Vayivka Bamakoim means that Yaakov encountered God. And the question is, isn't it strange that we use the word Hamakoim to refer to God? Why wouldn't the pasuk say, Vayivka Bahashem? He encountered God. As we are familiar, indeed, that he went to sleep, and he had a dream, and he had a vision, and he encountered God. Why are we using the words Hamakoim or Bamakoim to refer to God Almighty? My friends, there is a gewaltic interpretation from Rabbi Aaron Karliner, not on this week's parsha, but on the portion of Eschanon. When we read the pasuk of Yahavta Eis Hashem Elokecha b'chol levavecha, right, part of the Shema, we should love God with all of our heart. Tells us Rashi b'chol levavecha. Look inside Rashi. Shaloi yehei lipcha choluk al hamakim. Loving God with all your heart means that your heart should not be contending with hamakim. Again, meaning your heart should not be fighting with God. Says Rab Aaron Karliner, if you were to interpret these words literally, you'll understand exactly what this means. Hamaki means your space, your place in life, your physical place in life, your emotional place in life, your circumstances of life, the family that you have in your life, your community in life, etc., etc. Many people spend a lot of energy rejecting, denying, not accepting their place in life. If only this, if only that. Says Rab Aaron Karliner that if you want to feel the love of God with all your heart, you have to embrace the place that you are in. Don't deny it. Don't reject it. Don't if only. We know that we are exactly where we are meant to be on all levels, that every single circumstance, the bigger picture, the little detail, the fact that I am here right now in this place physically, in this place emotionally, in this place mentally, I was placed here by God, and I need to embrace the space that I am in. Rejecting my space is rejecting God. Embracing my space is expressing my love towards God Almighty. But hold on. Lest one think that embracing one's space means that a person should be content with things the way they are. No, mamish the opposite. Embracing one's space means that I acknowledge, I accept that I am exactly where God places me to be in order for me to fulfill my mission in this place, which always will be to upgrade, to bring more divine light. Yelchu mechayel al choyel. As we have the beautiful story related many times from Rabbi Jonathan Sachs of blessed memory, that when he had his first yichidus with the Rebbe in 1968, he was then a university student in Cambridge, traveling here in America, meeting many Jewish leaders, and he, so to say, was interviewing the Rebbe. So after he finished asking all the questions that he prepared to ask, all of a sudden the Rebbe began to interview him. The Rebbe asked him, how many Jewish students do you have in Cambridge? How connected are they to the Yiddishkeit? And the main question the Rebbe asked Rabbi Sachs, and what are you doing about it? So his first reaction was by telling the Rebbe that in the situation in which I currently find my place. And before he continued, the Rebbe, uncharacteristic of the Rebbe interrupted him, and the Rebbe tells him, a Jew doesn't find himself in a place. That you were placed in that location for a mission. And your mission is, and as the Rebbe went on to inspire him indeed, to bring a lot more Yiddishkeit in his surroundings. And he shares many times over that he learned a dual, almost a paradoxical message from the Rebbe, that one needs to embrace the place that one is on, that one is in. We are not finding ourselves by accident anywhere. We were placed here by God, but being placed here by God means that we are placed there for a mission, and the mission is to change the place that we are in, to upgrade the place that we are in, to better the place that we are in. Many years back, when Ashoy Ubenois Chabad had their yearly conference in Detroit, it was sometimes in the 60s, many women from Crown Heights flew to Detroit. They had their conference, and on a Friday early morning when they went to the airport planning to fly back to Crown Heights, there was a Zaz snowstorm that all the planes were grounded. And these women needed to call home to notify their families the situation. In those days, they went to the payphones. The woman in charge of the Crown Heights group, a Mrs. Popak, a Rebbetzin Popak, she decided that she's going to call up the Rebbe's office to notify the office, to notify the Rebbe that they are stuck in Detroit. And indeed, she calls the Rebbe's secretary. Rabbi Klein of blessed memory picks up the phone. And she tells Rabbi Klein to notify the Rebbe that the group of Neshay, we are stuck in Detroit. Rabbi Klein asks her to wait on the line. Few moments later, Rabbi Klein gets back on the line with her, and she's putting in her nickels or her quarters, however, whatever currency was needed then to feed the payphones. And he tells Rebbetzin Popak that the Rebbe doesn't understand the word stuck. Okay, so she thinks, you know, immigrants, we have to explain the word in English. She begins to explain to Rabbi Klein what the word stuck means. Rabbi Klein interrupts her, and he tells her, the Rebbe knows what the word stuck means. The Rebbe rejects the concept that a Jew is stuck anywhere. If you are in Detroit in an airport because of a snowstorm, there's a reason why God put all of you over there. Now go find the mission. Go find your purpose. She says she was so inspired that she gathered all the women and they went in the airport. This is in the 60s. Mamash Mifzayim, stopping people, are you Jewish? Inspiring people to light Shabbos candles that week. There are many families that are Fruma families today because of the group of Neshei or Chabad women that were stuck in Detroit. And coming back to the parsha, and how inspiring is this, and how important is this for us, that we go into the week with the knowledge that Vayifka Bamokim, that we will embrace our place. This is the way we embrace God. We embrace our place by acknowledging that we are exactly where we need to be. And we have a mission. And our mission is to enlighten up, to liven up, to better our place. And God willing, when we fulfill our mission, when I bring a little bit of light into my place that God put me in, and you will add a little bit of lichtigkeit in the place that God put you in, so my light and your light and our collective light certainly will usher in the ultimate light in the world. And may we merit through our avoda to finally bring down Mashiach Tzidkenu. And may we dance in Vayetze. We should be leaving the opposite. We should be leaving the Charoi Nafshal Olam. And it's high time that we should be returning to Be'er Sheva. We should be returning to our holy country, to our holy city of Yerushalayim. With the coming of Mashiach Tzidkenu now, Amen, Agutevach.